Hi everyone, welcome you all. In the today's video, I'm going to show you how we can achieve grouping concept in Playwright. So basically why we need grouping. So sometimes you may have n number of test cases and we need to group them into multiple categories, right? Some of them are belongs to sanity, or some of them are regression, some of them are functional. So like this, we can group the tests. So whenever you want to execute a specific group of tests, we should be able to execute. So for that, grouping concept is very much important in automation. So how can we achieve this grouping concept in Playwright? So let us see. So the first thing, I already created a grouping.spec.js file. And let me write some of the tests. And once you return the test, then we will see how we can group them. So first thing, let me write some tests, sample tests. So for that, I'm trying to import Playwright test and expert functions from Playwright test module. So for that, I can write one simple statement, import. Or you can directly say, instead of creating import, simply we can also say const. So this is also a right statement. You can simply say from Playwright test, we can get test or expect functions. So other way is we can also do like this import statement. By using import statement also, we can import the functions from the models. You can import, and in this we can specify. So test and also expect from same thing from @playwright/test. So either you can do this way or you can do this way. We can import simply functions from the module. Okay, now let me start writing some test sample tests. Let's say whenever you want to write a new test, we use something called test functions, test dot implicit test, and here we can specify the title of the test. Suppose I'm say test one. And then we need to write for asynchronous function here. I can say asynchronous. And inside this, we can normally pass page fixture. I can pass page. And then we need to write one arrow function. So in this function, we can write all the steps, automated steps. So for now, I'm just writing simple console message. And I'm not going to write any automation script. Just I want to show you how we can achieve the grouping concept here. Okay, let's try to understand the concept. So I'm just trying to print something, console.log. And in this, I'm saying this is test one. This is my test one. I can simply write some message. This is my test one. Now, similarly, let me create some more test. Let's say this is my test one, test two, test three, and test four. Okay. Now I can say this is my test one. This is my test two. And this is my test three. And this is my test four. So I have created multiple tests. Okay, so once you created this test, if you want to execute all the tests, we can simply execute and save the file and go to the terminal. And now we can just run this command npx playwright test. And inside the test, grouping is my file name, grouping.spec.js, and project is Chromium. And then I'm running in the headed mode. Let me try to execute. Okay, now it is successfully executed. Now you can see all four are got executed, and also by default, they are passed. And if I look at here, all console messages, I can see here, test one, and I have not changed my console.log message. So it is printed everything as a test one. So let me also try to change this message. This is my test two, and this is my test three. And then this is my test four. Okay, now save the file and then execute one more time. And all the tests are executed. And now you can see test one, test two, test three, four are successfully executed. Fine. So now I want to execute or want to group these tests in multiple groups. Okay. I want to make this test as part of multiple groups. So what we can do is we need to use something called a describe block. So all the tests we can keep inside the describe. So describe is always representing a group. So what I will do is first two tests, one and two, I will make one group. And test three and four, I will make another group. Okay. So for that, what you can do is we can just write one describe block. So to write the describe block, we can simply say test.describe. And in this, we can specify the title of the group. So let me call it as a group one. And apart from the group, we can write one asynchronous function. You can say simply bracket. An arrow function we can write. Okay, so simply we can say group. And here in this particular describe block, we can keep all the tests. Now I'm copying test one and test two. and remove from here and keep it inside the first block. Now these two tests are comes under one group, that is group one, right? So now similarly, I will also create one more describe block, and then I will make 3 and 4 as part of that group. So I'm creating one more describe block, test.describe, and again, title of the group, I'll name it as group two. And now one asynchronous function we need to write. So inside this group two describe block, I will keep test 3 and test 4. So these two tests I will keep inside the second group like this. Okay, now two different groups I have created. One is group one, second one is a group two. In the group one, I have test 1 and test 2. In the group two, I have a test 3 and test 4. Okay, now let us try to execute. So when I execute this, I clear and then execute. And now you can see both the groups have successfully executed. And here you can see 4 all passed. All 4 tests are passed from the both the groups. Okay. So now suppose, okay, I have added all the groups and all the tests in the different groups. Now what I want to do is I want to add hooks along with this both the groups. I want to also use hooks. So if you want to add hooks for this particular test, so we can just add outside of the describe block. So here we have written one describe block, and here we have written another describe block. So before writing all the describe block, here you can write all the hooks, whatever you want. For example, let's write one hook here, test.beforeall. So in the previous video, we already discussed about hooks concept. Same thing I'm using here. Before all, and here we need to write asynchronous function. And let's try to implement something in this. Asynchronous is a function, arrow function. So in this, I'm just writing a simple console message, console.log. Okay, and I can say this is before all hook. This is before all hook. Similarly, I will try to create multiple hooks. I can say after all, and this is after all group. And similarly, I will also create one more block, and before each hook, and this is also before each hook. And similarly, I will create one more hook called after each. This is after each, and here I can say this is after each. Okay, now I have created 4 different type of hooks. Before all will execute once before starting all the test. After all will execute after completion of all the test. Before each will execute multiple times before starting every test. And after each will execute multiple times after completion of every test. Okay. Now how many groups I have? Totally 2 groups I have. Group 1 and group 2. Group 1 contains a 2 tests. Another group 2 contains a 2 more tests. Test 3 and test 4. Okay. Now let us execute and see whether it is executing the same order or not. So let me run this command, npx playwright test and grouping.spec.js and project promium --hated. Okay, now we can see all of them are successfully executed. Now we can see the in which order they have executed. Now we can see before all hook is executed only once before starting all the test, and after all hook is executed only once after completion of all the test. Now you can look at here, before each and after is executed for every test, and this is my test 2, and this is my test 3, before each and after each, and this is my test 4, again before each and after each. So after all is executed after completion of all the tests in the file. Okay, so apart from these groups, we can also specify different type of hooks in our test, and we can execute all the tests from all the groups. Okay. Suppose I have multiple groups here. Let's say group 1 and also we have a group 2. Suppose I want to execute only specific group of test. So when I run the test, by default, all the tests are executed. Now, if you want to execute specific group of tests, so then what we can do is, in the test itself, you can specify one more option called only. For example, I want to execute only group one tests. So simply what you can say, test.describe.only, you can specify this option. So if you specify this option, so only the describe block will be executed. So whatever the tests which are there in the describe block, only those test methods will be executed. Okay, now let me clear this and then execute one more time. Okay, so now you can see here, four tests are got executed. And here you can see only group describe two. So only this one is got executed. We say test.describe.only. You can say before each test three is got executed, test four is got executed, even test one and test two is also got executed. Okay, so it should not executed. We can execute only specific group of tests. Now let us see why it is executed all the stuff. So after we have done changes, we haven't saved the file. So let me save the file, go to the file and save. And now I'm going to run only the particular group. So that I have mentioned is group one only. Okay, let's go and execute the test once again. Whenever you do some changes in the test, always try to save it and then execute. Otherwise, it will execute the last changes. Okay, now it is executed. And now you can see the console window. This time it is executed. You can save here. Test 1, test 2, and test 3. You can see here test 1 and test 2 both are got executed from the first block. And the second group, it is not executed. Test 3 and test 4 are not executed. And again, all the hooks as usual executed. Before all, after all, before each and after each. Here also one more time, before each and after each. So only two tests got executed from the first describe block. Okay, and there is one more option is there. Suppose if you want to, I have two groups, I want to skip one of the group. So instead of only, you can also specify one more option. Suppose I can say skip. So this particular option will automatically skip the first group. And now it will execute only second group of test. So let's try to execute and see, save it and then execute. It will skip the first group. Then it will execute only the second group of test methods. So you can just look at here, both two tests are got already skipped. So only two are got executed and passed. You can look at here, only the third one, test three and test four got executed from the second group. And first and second are not executed from the first group. So this is another option which we have, skip or only. So by using these options, we can simply control the groups and we can execute whichever group of tests we want to execute in the Playwright. So this is how we can simply achieve the grouping concept by using describe block. So all the tests should be part of particular describe. And then this is comes under one group. And if you want to create another group, then you can write another describe block. So like this, we can create any number of describe blocks to representing the multiple groups in our Playwright. Okay. So that's all for this video. Next video, we will discuss another concept. Thanks for watching.